Now, First Alert Weather with meteorologist Tyler Jankowski.
Tyler, tell us about our weather. What are we looking at?
Well, pretty nice. If you thought today was a little bit on the cool side, tomorrow will be about 10 degrees warmer. So that
nice.
Is good news, especially if you're headed out early tomorrow morning shopping. That's the view of the State House in Montpelier. It's a dry scene right now. I think it should be that way the whole night. There might be a little flakage, a little flurry activity in the Champlain Valley, but I don't think it makes it as far east as Montpelier. We're watching for a little bit of a lake effect band to come off of Lake Ontario. It has not developed yet, so we'll be watching for that this evening. Otherwise, it's just cloudy out there right now, and that's why temperatures really won't budge overnight. So you basically look at where you are right now, and that's where you should be 12 hours from now. It's 28 in Montpelier, 31 in the Champlain Valley, 27 in Saranac Lake. So it's plenty cold for snow. And I do think southern St. Lawrence County, southern Franklin County in New York could see maybe a quick inch tonight. You'll see that here on Futurecast. See how it just develops there? This is midnight. We'll be on late tonight after the football game with an update. So I think it'll be snowing in a couple of towns there by later on. But that's it. I mean, a flurry might make it farther than that, but not much else to talk about tonight. Temperatures stay right about where they are. 26 in Saranac Lake tomorrow morning, 27 in Rutland, and 25 in Montpelier. Now, we do start with a lot of clouds, not much falling from them, though, other than a flurry here or there. I do think the sunshine will increase, but we really don't have much of a window tomorrow. We're in between systems, so I think the farther south you are, the more sun you see tomorrow. If you're right along the Canadian border, there may be more clouds as we go through the day, but I think it's a dry day from start to finish. And there you see the 43, that's the high. So we only made it to 31 today. That's the difference going into tomorrow. And again, a little bit of sunshine there midday. 42 in Middlebury, 43 will do in Rutland. The wind is not a factor early on, but it'll change. We're watching a front approach. So by tomorrow evening, if you're still out, not tired enough to head in, it will be gusty out there. 30 miles per hour, definitely a possibility out of the south by late tomorrow evening. And we do warm up going into Saturday. And unfortunately, that means the next weather maker is all rain. Now, the good news is it's not a lot. It's only a few showers moving through. This is 4 o'clock on Saturday, so I think the chance for a shower increases on Saturday. But that's all we're talking about. It's not a widespread heavy rain, just a couple of showers moving through. And then it turns colder, maybe even a few snowflakes here going into early Sunday. But I think Sunday turns out mainly cloudy and a lot colder. I mean, look at this drop, 45 on Saturday, 33 on Sunday, and we hold at 33 going into Monday before we climb into the 40s. Average is in the lower 40s, so Sunday and Monday will be below average for this time of year. So here's the recap in the 5 day plus two. The rain showers in here Saturday. That's the cold front, so we drop into the 30s with clouds on Sunday, a couple of rays of sunshine. And if you're looking for snow, I think there's a little disturbance that comes through Sunday night into early on Monday. That could put down a quick inch in a couple of spots. We have to keep an eye on that. Then we dry out on Tuesday, and then a couple more rain showers there early on Wednesday. That's how it looks for now. Renee, back to you.